So, what is learning? In each of our brains, we have about 100 billion neurons or brain cells. When we encounter new information, it is transmitted by synapses along neural pathways. Learning occurs when we create and strengthen these pathways in our brain based on input. But what if I told you that the way we think about learning may be completely wrong? In order to learn, you must have a teacher to teach something, right? In 1999, Sugata Mitra put a computer kiosk that only functioned in English in a remote village 300 miles outside of Delhi, where kids had never seen or interacted with a computer before. After 3 months, when he returned, the children said to him, "We need a faster processor and a better mouse." When Sugata asked them how they knew this, the children responded, "You have given us a machine that only works in English, so we have had to teach ourselves English in order to use it." This was an incredible finding, and curious to see how far this notion of self-learning can go, Sugata set up a new computer to only have information on the biotechnology of DNA replication in English, and he set this up to be an impossible experiment, thinking that there was no way the children could learn the new information. And when he returned, the children told him that they hadn't learned anything and sounded discouraged, but when he asked them further, a little girl said to him, "We try every day, but apart from the fact that improper replication of DNA causes disease, we haven't learned anything else." Amazing. And to this point, Sugata remarks, "It's not about making learning happen, it's about letting learning happen." Many people complain about school, but as Sugata points out, our school system was built for an era where we needed to be able to memorize things and work under pressure, such as on standardized tests. But that is an outdated system. We now live in an age of technology where actually knowing things is becoming obsolete because the information is right at our fingertips. And although we all seem to hate school, humans actually like learning. In fact, when we learn, our brains release dopamine, which is the same chemical in the brain that is released by drugs such as marijuana and cocaine, as well as during sex. In fact, one of those towns Sugata put a kiosk in, he asked a friend of the children who did not know the material to simply encourage the children by asking them questions, engaging them, etc. And when he tested the children again, their scores jumped to 50%. So why do we seem to hate learning? As lifelong teacher Rita Pearson points out, in our school systems, we seem to celebrate failure. She goes on to say that somewhere along the line, we started to think that if I point out to you what you don't do or what you didn't do, it will inspire you to do. Our current system utilizes systematic negative reinforcement to try and facilitate learning, but is negative reinforcement better? In a study about rugby, players were given video feedback after one of their games. Half the players were shown a positive reel with highlights, while the other half was shown a negative reel, highlighting their failures throughout the game. A week later at the next game, the players who were shown the positive reel outperformed those who were shown the negative one. So could it be our emphasis on our failures that is ultimately holding us back from making those neural connections that we need in order to learn? Thank you.